Morning, guys. It's Thursday, January the 4th, 2024. Today's going to be two pumps with a one squat chaser. It's going to be for a minimum of 50 reps to give me my 100 push-ups, which is the standard going forward for however longer. I'm doing quite a few more short sessions, focusing on multiple pump or some recovery, and so some days it might just end up being 101 pumps followed by squats after. Nothing's really planned until I get here and I see how I feel, and then I come up with something and I go with it. But I'll do some pull-ups afterwards, probably some pranayama afterwards as well. Right now, really, the focus is on short sessions, minimalist style, and just getting the reps in. Focusing on strength, maybe, I don't know, in the back of my mind, I'd say putting on a little bit of muscle because I'm doing the multiple pump sets. But really, my diet doesn't, I'm not taking in the excess calories where I'm going to put on a ton of muscle. But if you can get the appearance of putting on more muscle, all the better. Not that my diet is bad, obviously. It's just that it is not aligned with muscle building as a priority. It's aligned for health, it's aligned for well-being. And having just as much, just enough muscle as you need, if that makes sense. So anyway, it's short. Two pumps, one squat chaser. Minimum 50 reps. I feel like doing a few extra, that's fine too. I got 20 minutes on the clock, but I'm not going to go for 20 minutes that I know of. Possibly tomorrow, though, I think might be a 20-minute session. 62 reps. 10 minutes. Here's the problem with nasal breathing. I never know when I'm done, if I'm gonna look at the camera and have all kinds of crap running down my nose. It started out feeling just a little congested, a little stuffed up, cleared up, as soon as I started moving with the nasal breathing. Closer. I think this should do it. The plan with pull-ups has been minimum of 10 reps a day. Usually done in 2 sets of 5. And then every couple of days I throw in a single weighted pull-up. I've been working with 15 pounds the past couple sessions. I'm going to stick with that for a little bit longer. It's also, the plan is to make each pull-up look aligned, full rep, dead hang, chin over the bar. Every rep should look pretty. Rest a minute. Another set of 5. I actually considered going longer with my burpees. 20-minute session might not have been out of order. However, as I mentioned, I'm trying to do everything. I'm trying to turn my burpees into my yoga practice. By that I mean, philosophically speaking, the goal of yoga is you approach each asana with steadiness and ease. I mentioned the description in Sthiram Sukham, which is the description in Patanjali's Yoga Sutras on how to do asanas. An asana is just to prepare you for sitting meditation. It settles the mind and just in the moment. So you, the goal isn't to manipulate the breath. It isn't to attempt to achieve anything. You just settle into the motion. And as you do that, stillness happens on its own, as just settling the breath. So I approach my burpee reps, nasal breathing, so that I settle into the repetition itself. I don't need to see how many I can get. I don't need to push it to any extent. I just need to get reps. That's the plan. Hi, Sura. Take another minute. One rep with 15 pounds coming up. So I'll be honest with you. I don't necessarily miss those hardcore 20-minute sessions, at least not right now. I'm enjoying the multiple pumps, and it just seems to be what's called for right now. After 2 years of doing tough sessions every single day, I feel like, not that any of that was wasted, I just feel like I'm settling in to what I should be doing right now. Alright, guys. One rep. 15 pounds. That's done. 3 sets of pull-ups. 10 minutes of burpees. 62 reps. My burpees making 124 push-ups total. Getting in my minimum, getting in what I need. So we're gonna go back to Kumbhaka breathing. Kumbhaka actually means retention, and that's basically what we're going to do, is working with breath retention. On the internal, we're going to breathe in, we're going to do a 1:2 ratio. So it means we breathe in for 4, we hold for a count of 8, we exhale for a count of 8. We can use Ujjayi breathing if we want to. Does provide a measure of control for the breath, which is important as well. It's a very soothing, calming means of breathing. It helps us get into the parasympathetic nervous state. I usually do so very lightly. The goal of Ujjayi breathing isn't to see how loud, how much sound you can make. It's simply to constrict the throat so that you gain a measure of control. We're going to put our hands in the Vishna mudra, Pranayama mudra. We're going to go for 3 minutes, so I don't need a count on the palm. So I'll have this hand in the chin mudra on my knee. We're going to start with 2 yogic breaths. Remember, the yogic breath is filling the belly, expanding the chest, breathing into the clavicles, exhaling from the clavicles to the chest. The belly. 2 breaths, and then we'll have a 10-second countdown, then we'll go right into the Kumbhaka breathing. Always through the nose, inhale through the nose, exhale through the nose. We're doing a internal breath hold, meaning we hold the breath, count of 8. It's a count of 8, not 8 seconds, so what your count is, just try not to rush it. Then we'll continue that for 3 minutes. Full yogic breath. sit comfortably. Relax your hands and the chin mudra on your lap, on your knees. Spine straight, relaxed. Shoulders relax. Neck and chin relax. Jaws relax. Easy, comfortable breathing. Bring your hands together. It's a little show of gratitude. Thankful for the breath, for the ability to breathe, for the clean air that we have. It's a very simple yet profound breath. There's no outgrowing breath work. There's no outgrowing the basics. You know, we often think that we need, through all of yoga, and our burpees as well, we think that we need to proceed, that we need to graduate, we need to get to another level. Honestly, there are no other levels. It's just the breath. There is a deep peacefulness, deep sense of peace in the stillness between every breath. And the Kumbhaka breathing with the breath retention allows us to fall into that stillness, allows us to fall into the silence, simply be, simply be relaxed. There's no need to do or accomplish anything in that silence. And the truth is, silence, stillness, is the background of existence. With that being said, that means there's really no true need to accomplish or do or be anything other than exactly what we are. Not saying don't try, don't set goals, don't try to achieve something, but to keep in mind that the greatest achievement, the greatest goal has already been made, and that is simple existence in itself. Everything after, it's just a bonus. Everything after is just beautiful. So, the hard work is done. You defy the odds. You're here. You exist. You're alive. And you're breathing. So, with that, guys, let's call it a day. I will see everyone later this afternoon. And we'll do some more talking. Thanks for joining me. If you haven't, click like, subscribe. And I appreciate it. You guys take care.